कि चीफ मिनिस्टर अरविंद केजरीवाल हैज बीन ग्रांटेड बेल बाय अ दिल्ली कोर्ट. अरविंद केजरीवाल फाइनली गेट्स बेल इन द लिकर गेट केस. जस्टिस बिंदु इन अ दिल्ली कोर्ट हैज जस्ट ग्रांटेड बेल टू अरविंद केजरीवाल इन द लिकर गेट केस. नो क्लैरिटी येट एज टू व्हेन द ऑर्डर ऑफ द राउस एवेन्यू कोर्ट इट्स ऑलरेडी कम. द हियरिंग हैज बीन ऑन सिंस द मॉर्निंग. ड्यूरिंग द हियरिंग the CBI and ED's vacation special judge Nyay Bindu has indicated she would not postpone the order, and late this evening bail has dropped. Bail has been granted to Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal. We're waiting on our reporters. Nalini Sharma is with us live. Nalini, take us through the details.
Well, Shiv, the big breaking news coming in. Our colleague Shrishti Ocha is breaking this information first on India Today. The Chief Minister of Delhi has been granted bail by the Delhi's Rouse Avenue Court. This is the first time in the first case in the Delhi Excise Policy where the trial court itself has granted bail. Because we've seen in other cases similar to Sanjay Singh where he had to fight all the way up to the Supreme Court, but regular bail has been granted. In fact, the ED pushed for a stay to appeal this order in the High Court, but there has been no stay that has been granted by the trial court judge, which essentially means that Arvind Kejriwal will be able to walk out of jail now. It's a big, big boost coming in for the Aam Aadmi Party. Earlier, he was out on interim bail granted by the Supreme Court to campaign for the Lok Sabha elections. But now regular bail has been granted to him, which means Arvind Kejriwal will be able to walk out of jail. Possibly not today because the time has already expired and it will take some time for the order to reach Tihar jail. But his lawyers are going to try and push for the release as early as possible. Possibly tomorrow we can see the Delhi Chief Minister once again coming out and joining the Aam Aadmi Party and taking up this entire ante that the opposition has been raking up regarding several issues that have been following the election results. It's a big boost for the Aam Aadmi Party. For the past couple of days, bail hearings have been going on. Before the Rouse Avenue Court, the ED had stringently opposed any grant of bail. But at the end of the day, the Rouse Avenue Court has granted the bail. We are still waiting, Shiv, for the detailed order to come out. So the grounds on the basis of which the bail has been granted, the conditions that have been imposed on him during the course of the time when he is going to be out on bail still remain to be disclosed. But nevertheless, it's a big, big boost coming in for the Aam Aadmi Party as well as the entire India Alliance. Because Kejriwal, over the course, since his arrest, has become one of the leading faces for the entire opposition. So it remains to be seen how the politics develops in the coming days. But right now, the trial court in the Delhi Excise Policy case has granted bail to the Delhi Chief Minister.
Nalini, Preeti here. Nalini, it's a huge boost, like you pointed out, where the Aam Aadmi Party is concerned. I can actually tell our viewers that the Aam Aadmi Party really wasn't expecting Arvind Kejriwal to get bail. Many a times, Nalini, you know that better. You know, the Rouse Avenue Court hasn't gone down very well when it comes down to bail for the Aam Aadmi Party leaders, especially Arvind Kejriwal. But this judge, Nyay Bindu, given bail to Arvind Kejriwal. There are two cases, Nalini, if you can help us decipher. Has he gotten bail in both cases? There's a PMLA case, there's a CBI case. Has Arvind Kejriwal gotten bail in both?
Well, Preeti, like our colleague Shrishti Ocha is breaking this information has confirmed, Arvind Kejriwal is not yet an accused in the CBI case. So because he is not yet an accused and not has been arrested in the CBI case, the bail was only a question in the prevention of money laundering case, which is being investigated by the ED, in which he has been granted bail. Like I was telling you earlier, the ED had opposed his bail. They had categorically told the court that Arvind Kejriwal, who they called the kingpin and the mastermind of the entire supposed liquor policy scam, should not be granted bail essentially because of his involvement as the national convener of the Aam Aadmi Party as well as the Delhi Chief Minister. But despite ED strongly opposing Arvind Kejriwal's bail, the court has still gone ahead and granted him bail. Now, whether or not the fact that Arvind Kejriwal has not resigned from his post and is still the sitting Chief Minister of Delhi, whether or not that played a role in court's decision is something that we will know only once the order from the court, the detailed order, is out. But for now, the court has granted bail. It is understandable that they might have imposed several conditions on it, several restrictions on it, what he can and cannot do.
Nalini, when you speak of the conditions that the court might have, the last time around, Arvind Kejriwal was given conditional bail to only come out and campaign because you were in the midst of election and the Aam Aadmi Party was fighting on 21 seats. And he was told very clearly that he was not going to be a part of any governance where Delhi was concerned. That was a precondition the last time around. Could that be a condition this time around as well?
Well, Preeti, first things first that we need to understand is that this is not an interim bail that has been granted to him. It is a regular bail that has been granted to him. Let me explain to you why that's important. Because the interim bail is only granted for a limited period of time, either for a particular purpose or for a limited period of time. When regular bail has been granted, it means that for the entirety of the case, till the time the Delhi excise policy case is going on, Arvind Kejriwal can be out on bail. This is similar to several other cases that we've seen, similar to National Herald, where we've also seen several other opposition leaders who are out on regular bail. Now, what the ED is going to do is that they're going to challenge this bail before the Delhi High Court. There is no doubt about that, because the way that they strongly opposed the bail before the trial court, there's no doubt about the fact that they will challenge it before the Delhi High Court, which is also why they were asking for a stay, a temporary stay on the order, to give them time to file an appeal before the Delhi High Court. But how soon they'll be able to do that, and whether or not the Delhi High Court will even overturn this decision, is something that we'll have to
wait and
watch.
That's a huge boost, Nalini, because that would mean now Arvind Kejriwal, in all probability, I'm sorry to interrupt you, in all probability is going to, of course, the ED is challenging the bail, is going to be now outside jail, at least for now, is what we're given to understand. Will that have any bearing, Nalini? Will it have any bearing on, say, a Manish Sisodia's case? Because they're two very different cases, a lot less evidence where Arvind Kejriwal's role is concerned. But could it have bearing on a Manish Sisodia? Because now it's over a year and a half that he's been in jail, where his trial hasn't even begun in the same the same case.
Well, that's an interesting question, Preeti, and we'll have to wait and see whether or not that happens. But the kind of investigation that has been done against Arvind Kejriwal in comparison to the kind of investigation against Manish Sisodia is very different. And I say that primarily because the entire probe that was against Arvind Kejriwal, the entire case that was made out against the Chief Minister, was made on the basis of statements that other people have given. On the other hand, Manish Sisodia, the ED had said, was directly involved in the formulation as well as the implementation of the excise policy. Whereas Arvind Kejriwal's involvement is other people who were part of the liquor policy had spoken about, on the basis of which Arvind Kejriwal was arrested. So there is very different kind of evidence against both Manish Sisodia and Arvind
Kejriwal. Exactly. So different kinds of evidence, two very different cases. Nalini, I'm coming in, and the reason I'm cutting you short is because we're going to bring in my colleague Srishti Ojha, who's joining us live for more. You know, Srishti, give us the latest, because at one point of time, the order was reserved. We were not expecting it today. What really went down? What happened in court?
Well, Preeti, as we know, the matter was heard by the vacation judge who heard the matter yesterday and today, and she'd made it very clearly yesterday that she will be pronouncing the order and will not reserve it for a later date. ED had made multiple attempts even yesterday before the court, seeking initially for a few more days to file their replies, and later on they also asked the court to reserve the order and then announce it later after the vacations are over. The court, the special CBI judge Niyai Bindu, had however very clearly said that considering that she knows that it's a very high profile matter, she spent 2 days hearing the matter, and she will make sure that the order comes in today itself, right after the hearing is over. We saw her sit till late evening, and the order was pronounced just a few minutes back, a positive order for Delhi's Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, where she's clearly said that he has been admitted to bail. All that needs to be done now is for Arvind Kejriwal to submit the bail bonds for 1 lakh tomorrow before the duty magistrate who will be sitting at Rouse Avenue Court. The ED had strongly opposed the bail order and also sought for a 48 hours time for the bail bonds to be filed, clearly saying that they would want to avail their remedies. Availing remedies here would basically mean that they would like to challenge the order before a higher court, the High Court being the appropriate court in this particular case. However, the court has today clearly refused to grant any such stay. The request for their stay, at least from Delhi's Rouse Avenue Court, has as of now been dismissed, and Arvind Kejriwal can walk out of jail tomorrow after the bail bonds, as long as the same is not challenged and the same the order is not stayed before the bail bonds are filed, are submitted before the court tomorrow. Back to you.
You know, Srishti, tell us a little bit more. What are the conditions that have been put this time around?
Well, Preeti, as the court clearly said today, a detailed order will, with the conditions, will be uploaded by tomorrow. And when the accused, when the bail bonds are submitted on behalf of the accused in cases of bail before the magistrate, is when the accused is also informed of the conditions that are being imposed on him. These conditions are the usual conditions which are imposed on people when they're granted bail. Conditions like that they're not supposed to tamper with the evidence, not influence witnesses, etc. As you were just discussing about the condition that was imposed by Supreme Court about Delhi's Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, when he was granted interim bail, he was asked to not perform his functions as a chief minister, etc. Those conditions are not likely and are not likely to be imposed in this particular case, because he has been granted regular bail here. He's not being released on interim bail. If he walks out after being granted regular bail in the money laundering case, then he will be able to perform his functions as the chief minister. That is not a condition which is usually imposed. An accused is not asked to not perform his functions once considering the job that he's part of outside, once he walks out of jail. So this is definitely a big relief, not just for Arvind Kejriwal, but also the Aam Aadmi Party, considering Kejriwal as of now is only an accused in the ED case and is not an accused in the CBI matter. Remember, his plea against his arrest, where he called his arrest illegal, is already pending before the Supreme Court. Now, while it will matter what the Supreme Court decides, it will not affect whether or not he's out or not, because he's already been granted bail by Delhi's Rouse Avenue court today.
Back to you. You know, viewers, one thing I can tell you, that this is huge for the Aam Aadmi Party. There were many factions within the Aam Aadmi Party that were actually looking at the fact of going into elections early next year with possibly Arvind Kejriwal in jail. This changes everything, of course. The bail will be challenged, as Nalini pointed out, and we're going to cut across to Nalini as well. I just want to go back, hark our viewers' memory back. March 21st, viewers, was when Arvind Kejriwal was arrested. He wasn't expecting it. He was arrested on the 21st of March. He spent over 50 days in jail. Then he was given interim bail to be out only to campaign, as the Aam Aadmi Party was contesting on 21 seats. And he was given that bail on the 2nd of June. He was once again, he went back, he surrendered, and he went back to jail. He wanted an extension on medical grounds for a week. That was denied to him, and now he has been given bail. Important to understand, like both my colleagues, Nalini and Trishti, are elucidating the difference between regular bail and interim bail. And interim bail works very differently, but regular bail, in all probability, from tomorrow morning, Arvind Kejriwal is back in business as the Delhi Chief Minister. It changes everything dramatically for the Delhi government as well for the Aam Aadmi Party. Nalini and Trishti, I want to bring you back in. And Nalini, if you just want to give us some perspective legally, this is a huge win for the Aam Aadmi Party. You know, the Aam Aadmi Party, at least, they'd be in shock, because I spoke with them, my sources, this afternoon. They were not expecting bail at all. They were thinking that it will only come when it comes from a higher court. So for this to happen at this point of time is a huge boost. But what could be now the legal implications, because the ED is bound to challenge the bail?
Well, Preeti, there are multiple different factors that might have played a role in this. And maybe Shishti can elaborate a little bit more on the judge who's been hearing this case, because the first judge who was hearing the case...
Stay with me, Nalini. I apologize. I'm interrupting you, both Shishti and Nalini. But we have with us Nalin Kohli, senior lawyer and a BJP spokesperson on the phone line with us. Mr. Kohli, I don't think the Aam Aadmi Party is expecting it, but this is huge. The Rouse Avenue court giving not interim but bail to Arvind Kejriwal. The ED is bound to challenge it. But as an advocate, as a senior lawyer, sir, you know better that this is big.
Well, actually, I tend to look at it differently. The process of bail is such that at some point or the other, an accused in a criminal case is bound to get it. It's only a matter of when and the circumstances that make a court consider whether bail should be granted or not. Mr. Kejriwal's colleagues are in jail for a fairly longer period of time. Now, Mr. Kejriwal, if he is granted bail, the court has felt probably that there is no need for him to be continuing to be in a jail or in terms of the investigation, how it's proceeding. Now, the ED will have its right to challenge it if it wishes. So I see it as a routine thing, but the bigger issue that Mr. Kejriwal has to face is the fact that he's an accused in a criminal case in which the chances of a charge sheet are very high. If a charge sheet has come, its cognizance is taken of the cognizance of the charge sheet, he'll have to face trial. So, while celebration of the legal team, by the legal team of Mr. Kejriwal, his family members will be okay to say, yes, we've got bail and we are celebrating that. The fact is, it's not the end of his legal problems. And that's going to be a journey that he will have to traverse, because the liquor scam is a serious scam, and they have not provided any answers satisfactorily till date. On the contrary, Mr. Kejriwal, as the media has reported, has been consistently evasive. He's not cooperative with his mobile phone, things like that. So I think his legal challenges are still there, which are there for a period of time for him to continue contesting.
You know, legal challenges might be there, but Nalin Kohli, for a political outfit where the Aam Aadmi Party was concerned, and many of your own leaders have come onto our channel to say that Arvind Kejriwal is going to spend the coming election in Delhi in jail in January. The ED might challenge it, but now that's a difficult prospect because he's back in business as the Delhi Chief Minister.
Well, actually, beyond Mr. Kejriwal's legal challenges, he has a serious political challenge that he has to answer to the people of Delhi, which is the water crisis. In fact, the BJP has tweeted a video of Mr. Kejriwal, and there are several videos actually of Mr. Kejriwal saying something before he came to be elected by the people and then never implementing it. So he's famous for speaking and talking big things but never working. So in Delhi's water issues, he has famously pointed out that Delhi has sufficient water. The problem is the leakage of water, the theft of water, the tanker mafia. And all we are now expecting, and the people of Delhi are expecting, that he will now follow his own advice that he was giving to the then government of Delhi about 10 years ago, and he can advise his minister instead of going on a fast to actually focus in solving the problem instead of blaming it to other states. So he has a fairly big political issue on hand too. He can't constantly get away by finding excuses or blaming somebody else for not working.
All right, Nalin Kohli, appreciate you joining us. I want to cut back to my colleague Nalini. We are also going to try and get in reactions from Aatishi and other senior leaders from the Aam Aadmi Party who'd be joining us shortly on the phone line, because viewers, for the Aam Aadmi Party, this is huge. And the reason why is because they were not expecting Arvind Kejriwal to get bail so quickly as he has. Nalini, I want to bring you in, and you wanted to touch upon Nyay Bindu, the judge, who heard the case on a vacation bench. Interesting. For Arvind Kejriwal to be granted bail, what were you saying?
Well, Preeti, I was talking about the fact that this case, the Delhi excise policy case, like you know, has been not only the different accused that have come before the court, but also different judges that have heard the case. So each judge has decided differently. And considering the fact that it was a vacation judge who was hearing this entire matter, whether or not that played a role in the fact that Arvind Kejriwal managed to get bail from the trial court itself is possibly something that Srishti can elaborate upon a little more, because she's been following the case very closely from the trial court. But having said that, let's focus on what the ED strategy is going to be now. ED is going to try and push and to get a stay on this bail order as soon as possible. Like you already know, they tried to get a stay from the Rouse Avenue court itself, but the judge categorically denied. In fact, it was only a 48-hour stay that they were asking, meaning that they would have prepared the appeal and filed it before a higher court within a period of 48 hours. But even that much amount of time has not been given to the ED, and the trial court judge has clearly said that there will be no stay on this order. So now that they've not got a stay on this order from this court, they are going to approach a higher court to try and get a stay on the order. But if they are not able to get a stay on the order, then that can mean that Arvind Kejriwal will be out for a long haul. So that might be a huge setback for the enforcement directorate, who've gone to the extent of calling him a kingpin in the case before the court of law. So it remains to be seen what happens in the coming days, because the ED is going to move very quickly before Arvind Kejriwal is able to get out of jail and gain some political momentum. They will be trying to get a stay on the order and put him back in jail as early as possible. Another very interesting thing to watch out is whether or not the CBI will now move in and arrest Arvind Kejriwal in the case or not, because that has not been done so far. He's still not an accused in the CBI case, like Srishti told us. So it remains to be seen whether or not that will play a role in trying to send Arvind Kejriwal back behind the bars in the Delhi excise policy case. But that is going to result in the same arguments being made by the opposition, that this is all political vendetta, and CBI and ED, the agencies, are being used as caged parrots by the government to kill
even if the CBI does move in right now, why it's been debated that this is a huge relief as well as a win for Arvind Kejriwal of sorts, because, like you pointed out, because over and over again, we had that argument and that narrative building that Arvind Kejriwal was the kingpin of the liquor scam. And if he has been granted bail in the manner in which he has, that puts a question mark on that theory as well. But the question that I'm asking you, Nalini, even if the CBI now moves in, all right, you know, Nalini just coming in, we're getting in political reactions, and I cut across to Nalini then.
Okay. आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता और सरकार में मंत्री सौरभ भारद्वाज है हमारे साथ बातचीत करने के लिए। सौरभ, एक बड़ी राहत की खबर आपके लिए सामने आई है, अरविंद केजरीवाल को बेल मिल गई है, इस पर आपकी पहली प्रतिक्रिया क्या है?
देखिए, हम न्यायालय का धन्यवाद करेंगे और सलाम करेंगे ऐसी जज को, उनके साहस को, कि जिस तरीके से केंद्र सरकार छोटे छोटे राजनीतिक दलों के पीछे पड़ी है, जिस तरीके से पूरी अपोजिशन को खत्म करने की कोशिश की जा रही है, ऐसे में इस तरीके के फैसले आना मील का पत्थर साबित होंगे। और मेरा मानना यह बड़ा मैसेज जो है सब जगह जाएगा, क्योंकि अक्सर ये देखा जा रहा था कि पीएमएलए के मामलों में लोअर जुडिशरी के जो जजेस थे वो बेल देने में थोड़ा सा संकोच करते थे, यहाँ तक कि हाई कोर्ट तक में भी बेल मिलने की मुश्किल हो रही थी और हर मामले को सुप्रीम कोर्ट तक जो है ले जाना पड़ रहा था, जो कि अपने आप में एक बॉटलनेक साबित हो रहा था, क्लॉक हो रही थी पूरी की पूरी जुडिशियल जो सिस्टम है, पूरा का जो जस्टिस डिलीवरी सिस्टम है वो पूरा का पूरा जो है वो फंस रहा था, जैसे बोतल मुंह पे फंस जाती है ना, जिसको कहते हैं कि बॉटलनेक क्लॉक हो रहा था। तो ये बहुत जरूरी है कि लोअर कोर्ट्स भी सभी तरीके के एक्ट्स और कानून के अंदर सभी तरीके के फैसले ले सके, उनके अंदर इतना कॉन्फिडेंस हो कि वे भी इस तरीके के महत्वपूर्ण फैसले दे सके।
इसमें सौरभ, मेरा सवाल ये है कि जो आपकी सरकार है दिल्ली में, उसके लिए ये कितनी बड़ी संजीवनी है अरविंद केजरीवाल को जमानत मिलना?
देखिए, अरविंद जी के आने से सरकार को जो दिशा मिलती है वो तो अपने आप में जो है बहुत बड़ी बात है। अरविंद जी होते हैं तो हर चीज का रोज डिस्कशन हो सकता है उनसे, कैबिनेट मीटिंग्स हो सकती हैं, बहुत सारी फाइलें हैं जिसके ऊपर हम भी फैसला करने से पहले मुख्यमंत्री जी से परामर्श करना चाहते हैं, और मुख्यमंत्री जी हैं जो पूरी सरकार को दिशा निर्देश देते हैं। मैं तो ये भी कहूँगा सरकार ही नहीं, पूरी पार्टी को भी स्ट्रैटेजी बताने में, कम्युनिकेशन समझाने में, आगे बढ़ाने में मुख्यमंत्री की जो भूमिका है, ऐसी भूमिका किसी की हो ही नहीं सकती, मतलब कोई आसपास भी नहीं है उनके। तो मेरा ये मानना है जब जब हमारी पार्टी के साथ कुछ बुरा हुआ है, भगवान जो है, हनुमान जी जो है, उनके लिए आए हैं, हमारी पार्टी की मदद के लिए आए हैं, और उन्होंने जो है किसी तरीके से भी संजीवनी, जैसे लक्ष्मण जी के लिए संजीवनी लाए हनुमान जी, ऐसे पार्टी के लिए भी संजीवनी जो है हर बार जो है हनुमान जी लाते हैं।
अब क्या आपकी जश्न की तैयारी रहेगी, क्या आप निर्देश दे रहे हैं तमाम वॉलंटियर्स को, ये और बता दीजिए।
देखिए, ऐसा तो अभी कोई प्लान हुआ नहीं, वो तो हम सब साथ ही बैठेंगे, साथ में चर्चा करेंगे, मगर मुझे लगता है कि बहुत सारी माओं की, बहनों की दुआएं जो है मुख्यमंत्री जी के साथ थी। जब जब हम बाहर निकलते थे लोग पूछते थे कब आएंगे भाई, कब आएंगे, कब आएंगे, और हम लोग भी ये मानते थे कि भैया लोअर कोर्ट में कुछ होगा नहीं, हाई कोर्ट में कुछ नहीं होगा, सुप्रीम कोर्ट में ही अंततः जो है कोई राहत मिलेगी। मगर इस तरीके से लोअर कोर्ट द्वारा राहत दिए जाना, मैं बता रहा हूँ ये पूरी जुडिशरी के लिए और पूरे हिंदुस्तान के लिए बहुत बड़ा मैसेज है, बहुत बड़ा पैगाम है।
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सौरभ भारद्वाज, हमारे साथ बातचीत कर रहे थे, और उनका कहना है कि हनुमान जी, मैं सवाल पूछ लेता हूँ। ओके, आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता और सरकार में मंत्री सौरभ भारद्वाज है हमारे साथ बातचीत करने के लिए। सौरभ, एक बड़ी राहत की खबर आपके लिए सामने आई है, अरविंद केजरीवाल को बेल मिल गई है, इस पर आपकी पहली प्रतिक्रिया क्या है?
देखिए, हम न्यायालय का धन्यवाद करेंगे और सलाम करेंगे ऐसी जज को, उनके साहस को, कि जिस तरीके से केंद्र सरकार छोटे छोटे राजनीतिक दलों के पीछे पड़ी है, जिस तरीके से पूरी अपोजिशन को खत्म करने की कोशिश की जा रही है, ऐसे में इस तरीके के फैसले आना मील का पत्थर साबित होंगे। और मेरा मानना यह है, बड़ा मैसेज जो है सब जगह जाएगा, क्योंकि अक्सर ये देखा जा रहा था कि पीएमएलए के मामलों में लोअर जुडिशरी के जो जजेस थे वो बेल देने में थोड़ा सा संकोच करते थे, यहाँ तक कि हाई कोर्ट तक में भी बेल मिलने की मुश्किल हो रही थी और हर मामले को सुप्रीम कोर्ट तक जो है।
तो मुझे लगता है कि अरविंद केजरीवाल का ऐसे वक्त में बाहर आना लोकतंत्र को मजबूती देगा और दिल्ली की जनता के लिए, देश की जनता के लिए आज बहुत खुशी का दिन है, बहुत बड़ी खबर है। हम सब लोग उत्साहित हैं इस खबर को सुन के और मैं माननीय न्यायालय का जो फैसला आया है उसको सर झुका के नमन करता हूं, बहुत बड़ा फैसला उन्होंने दिया।
इन्फोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट के तमाम बयानों को आज के कोर्ट में किस तरीके से देखते हैं और जिस तरीके से
इन्फोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट का जो बयान अब तक रहा है वो झूठ की बुनियाद पर रहा है और यही अगर मैं बार बार इस बात को कहता था कि भाई न्याय करने पर अगर कोई भी जज आ जाएगा तो इस केस में तो कुछ दम है ही नहीं है। एक बेबुनियाद झूठा केस अरविंद केजरीवाल को फंसाने के लिए बनाया गया था, प्रचार से दूर करने के लिए उनको जेल में भेजा गया था। तो इसलिए ये माननीय न्यायालय ने इस बात को समझा और दूध का दूध पानी का पानी हो गया।
देखिए इस बेल के ऑर्डर के आने के बाद भारतीय जनता पार्टी के और भाजपा के साथ साजिश करने वाले तमाम लोगों के चेहरे पर काली की है। ये सच्चाई की जीते हम डे वन से कह रहे हैं कि पूरा का पूरा मामला फेक है, फर्जी है। हम कोर्ट के इस फैसले का सम्मान करते हैं सर झुका के। और आप देखिएगा आज अरविंद जी बाहर आ रहे हैं, इस फर्जी आरोप में जितने भी नेता आम पार्टी गिरफ्तार है सब लोग बाहर आएंगे सत्य में उजेते। आम आदमी पार्टी पूरी ताकत से भारतीय जनता पार्टी के अत्याचार के खिलाफ कल भी लड़ रही थी, आज भी लड़ रही है और आने वाले वक्त भी लड़ेगी। सत्य में जीते सच्चाई की जीत हुई है भाजपा के चेहरे पर काली पुती फैसले कहने के बाद।
Alright, the आम आदमी पार्टी क्लियरली टेकन अबैक बट एक्सटैटिक अंडरस्टैंडेबली। अरविंद केजरीवाल is now going to be out in bail. This is not interim bail. He's got bail from a lower court. What does this actually mean? Well, for Delhi politics, it means that he's back in business as the chief minister starting tomorrow itself. Atishi was to sit on a fast until death, keeping in mind the water crisis which the national capital has been facing. Delhi has been locked in a political fight with neighbor Haryana, the neighboring government of BJP over water, where Delhi has alleged that Haryana is not letting enough water or as mandated by a memorandum in 1994, allowing that much water as well to come through. And on that, Atishi was to sit on a fast, but everything changes from now on, viewers, because Arvind Kejriwal will, in all probability, walk out of jail tomorrow. He's to give a bond of 1 lakh rupees, and in all probability, we are looking at, in the afternoon, Arvind Kejriwal walking out on bail. This is huge. The ED on its own will be moving in for a stay. Let's listen into reactions and we'll cut across to reporters.
आज मैं माननीय कोर्ट को धन्यवाद करता हूं, माननीय जस्टिस साहिबा को धन्यवाद करता हूं। मुझे यह लगता है कि आज का दिन ये साबित हुआ जो अरविंद केजरीवाल पहले दिन से कह रहे थे कि ये भ्रष्टाचार की जांच नहीं हो रही है, ये अरविंद केजरीवाल जी को आम आदमी पार्टी को बदनाम करने की साजिश सुझा रही है। आज जो अरविंद केजरीवाल डे वन से कह रहे थे आज साबित हुआ और माननीय कोर्ट ने दूध का दूध पानी का पानी कर दिया। भ्रष्टाचार कहीं नहीं है, झूठे खेत में सभी नेताओं को बताया गया है, तो अब दूध का दूध पानी का पानी देश के सामने है।
इन्फोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट के उन तमाम बयानों को जो कोर्ट में आज दिया गया इन्फोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट की तरफ से उसको किस तरीके से कहीं ना कहीं अब आम आदमी पार्टी के संगठन को बल मिलेगा क्योंकि
देखिए जो ये वकील उनके ये कहानी बता रहे हैं अब देश की एक एक जनता को याद हो गया। सुप्रीम कोर्ट में वही कहानी, हाई कोर्ट में वही कहानी, लोअर कोर्ट में वो कहानी, अब उसका वकील शुरू करता है जनता के साथ अब ये कहने वाला है। तो कहानी के बुनियाद पे आप किसी को प्रमाण बंद नहीं कर सकते, कुछ दिन तो रख सकते हो। आज ये साबित हुआ कि पूरी की पूरी कहानी भारतीय जनता पार्टी को रची गई, ईडी किरदार था और वकील वही कहानी कोर्ट में कह रहा था। आज जो बेल मिला है इससे ये साबित होता है कि अरविंद केजरीवाल जी पहले दिन जो कह रहे थे कि ये केवल फंसाने की साजिश है, पॉलिटिकल वेंडेटा लेने की कोशिश है, आज वो साबित हुआ।
ठीक है, बहुत शुक्रिया सर।
Colleague Nalini back with us. We also have Aishwarya who's joining us from the ground and as well as Amit Bhardwaj tracking all reactions coming in from the Aam Aadmi Party. Nalini, once again, take us through, a vacation bench under Judge Nyay Bindu giving in bail to Arvind Kejriwal as well. In all probability, he will walk out tomorrow after giving a bond of 1 lakh rupees. What does this mean legally for Arvind Kejriwal?
Well, Preeti, it's a big win. I'll tell you why. Because under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, the reason why everybody says it's a very stringent law, it's very difficult to get bail, is because bail can be granted only when it's proven that the accused did not have any involvement in the entire money laundering aspect. So the fact that the trial court has granted bail to Arvind Kejriwal in the ED case, under the PMLA case, means that Arvind Kejriwal's involvement in the Delhi excise policy case, it's itself is questionable, which might lead to larger ramifications in the entire Delhi excise policy case, because the ED has claimed that Arvind Kejriwal was the kingpin. So if the kingpin itself, his prima facie, it is not proven that he was in the know-how of everything that was happening, then it might mean that the entire case might fall apart. The second important thing that the ED has to do, something that even the Supreme Court has questioned them on, is proving that there is a money trail and showing the chain of events through which the money trail actually transpired. So as to whether or not they have been able to do that in Arvind Kejriwal's case, there is a big question mark on that now because of this trial court order. Like I told you earlier, it's tomorrow that we are expecting for the detailed order of the trial court to be out. So we still have to understand to what extent ED has been able to prove its case before the trial court or not, or on basis of what reasons a bail has been granted to Arvind Kejriwal. Like I was telling you earlier, there might be a factor in play about the fact that Arvind Kejriwal is still not resigned and the Delhi chief minister is currently in jail until he is released on bail. So that might have played a factor on the vacation judge to grant him bail so that the regular functioning of the national capital can continue unhindered. But we still have to wait for the detailed order to be out. Also, it will be only tomorrow that we can expect Arvind Kejriwal to walk out of Tihar jail where he is currently lodged. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, the ED will also be moving really quickly to file an appeal before a higher court challenging his bail and to seek a stay on the bail order as early as possible. That can only be done once a detailed order is out, but we'll have to wait and see exactly how the things proceed in the coming few days because there are going to be fast-paced developments.
Well, fast-paced developments, will the CBI also move in? But not only the question that I was asking you earlier, and we're going to cut across to Aishwarya as well, who's joining us outside the Aam Aadmi Party headquarter. But, very quickly, even if the CBI moves in at this point of time, the case is very different where the PMLA-ED case is concerned and vis-a-vis the CBI.
Well, absolutely, Preeti, because the ED is only going to be investigating the money laundering aspect, whereas the CBI is going to be investigating the larger corruption angle as to whether or not there was any actual corruption when it comes to the Delhi excise policy case. But what remains to be seen is whether or not they actually go ahead and pull Kejriwal into the CBI case right now or not, because still now he is not an accused in the case. True. But that is something that we see often happening. If you remember, even when P. Chidambaram had gotten arrested in the INX case, immediately after he was arrested by the CBI, the ED had soon moved in to arrest him and take him into custody. So he had to go back to jail almost immediately under the ED case. So it remains to be seen as to whether or not a similar pattern is followed, but even in the other Kejriwal case.
But Nalini, this time,
the CBI has still not acted.
But this time, contrary to Chidambaram's arrest, the sequence of events are different and that will play a huge factor because it's way easier to get bail in a CBI case right now on the same case than an ED PMLA case. So a huge difference there. I'll cut across to Nalini on that. I'm going to go to now Aishwarya joining us in front of the Aam Aadmi Party headquarter. Aishwarya, the AAP cadre and the leaders will be taken aback by the end of day. They were planning to put up a tambu somewhere in Jorbagh, in the south of Delhi, Jangpura, if I'm not wrong, so that Atushi could sit on a fast unto death protesting the water crisis in Delhi. And suddenly they have some fabulous news coming their way. Okay, we don't have Aishwarya. Amit, do you want to take that question?
Yes, Preeti, you know, absolutely. As I was saying, you know, this is possibly the moment when Aam Aadmi Party was least expecting the bail of Arvind Kejriwal. And they were more troubled and busy with the questions of governance in the national capital, including the water crisis. And that's why the Atishi, the water minister of the national capital, had announced to go on indefinite hunger strike, satyagraha from tomorrow. But today, you know, things have just changed. It is the biggest relief for Aam Aadmi Party, and at a time when they were hardly expecting this. Why I'm saying this? Because in case of Sanjay Singh as well, or rather there has been a perception within the Aam Aadmi Party that the lower court will reject your bail, then you'll have to approach the Delhi High Court. There'll be no relief from Delhi High Court either, and eventually you'll have to approach the Supreme Court, from where you might get some sort of relief. And that has been a pattern. You know, you look at Sanjay Singh's case, what happened, what kind of observations were made till the Delhi High Court, and eventually he got bail in the Supreme Court. So Aam Aadmi Party was not expecting any kind of relief, to be honest, in this particular case from the lower court. But the lower court has given bail to Arvind Kejriwal. He's expected to walk out of the jail tomorrow at a bail bond of rupees 1 lakh. And, you know, now what we are given to understand that the leadership of Aam Aadmi Party is rushing to CM residence, and where I'm actually heading to right now. Sanjay Singh, Dilip Pandey, Sanjeev Jha, all these leaders have already reached CM residence. It is to be seen as to whether Sunita Kejriwal will speak, because definitely this is the moment least expected by any of the Aam Aadmi Party leaders. And it comes, you know, barely 2 weeks after the results of the Lok Sabha have been announced. We have to note out here that when Arvind Kejriwal had stepped out earlier, it was on special conditions so that he can campaign during the Lok Sabha elections. But this time, this is a regular bail that is being given to Arvind Kejriwal. Back to you.
Well, you know, for the Aam Aadmi Party, this is huge. Bhagwant Mann, the Punjab chief minister, tweeted a short while back, and he says, Adalat par bharosa hai, Kejriwal ji ki zamanat, satya ki jeet. You know, this is going to be now the narrative which, of course, the Aam Aadmi Party will play. But we're politically speaking, you know, viewers, kid you not, this is the toughest time that Arvind Kejriwal and the Aam Aadmi Party is going through. The showing in the Lok Sabha has been far from adequate for the Aam Aadmi Party, and there'll be a lot of stock taking. Amit Bhardwaj has some more news. Go ahead, Amit. Amit, you wanted to say something? Okay, we don't have Amit. Right now, we're going to try and cut across to Amit Bhardwaj. But, viewers, like I said, this politically is a time of stock-taking for the Aam Aadmi Party. The Lok Sabha showing for the Aam Aadmi Party was far from adequate, like I pointed out. All seven seats where the national capital are concerned, the Aam Aadmi Party fought with the Congress, lost all seven. The Aam Aadmi Party fought in four of those seven. One seat, the Aam Aadmi Party fought of Kurukshetra in the state of Haryana, the Aam Aadmi Party lost. That one seat that the Aam Aadmi Party fought in the state of Gujarat, the Aam Aadmi Party lost. Their showing, even in the state of Punjab, was far from what the Aam Aadmi Party would have wanted. So it is a time where the party's got its back towards the wall, but this is going to prove, at least for the political outfit and Arvind Kejriwal, a huge, huge boost.